Welcome to BioBalance Healthcast, episode number 472, an interview with Nick Ahlering, owner of Orangetheory. BioBalance Health features conversations about anti-aging medicine. Your hosts are Dr. Kathy Maupin, medical director of BioBalance Health, and a leading expert in treating symptoms of aging, and Brett Newcomb, a licensed professional counselor. Dr. Maupin and Brett are the authors of The Secret Female Hormone, the seminal work about testosterone replacement therapy for women, and Got Testosterone, the newly released book for men that helps men choose the most effective and safe form of T replacement. These books are available on Amazon or from Dr. Maupin's office at BioBalance Health in St. Louis and in Kansas City. Dr. Maupin's office is currently accepting new patients.
Today we're going to talk about the fastest growing fitness studio in the United States, Orangetheory. And we're going to give you some ideas about how you can go to Orangetheory and have a fitness program made for you and lose weight and become stronger. And today we have a special guest, Nick Ahlering, who is the owner and manager of the Ladue Orangetheory, the first and the busiest Orangetheory in St. Louis. Nick, I'm so glad that you're here. I welcome you with open arms. We've known each other for a long time, and his parents have known me for a long time. And Nick has done something that is truly amazing, brought this wonderful franchise to St. Louis, where many of our patients that we send to get thinner, to get healthier, and to get stronger. And Nick's Orangetheory site or spa is actually doing the work that I would have to do if I would have to be teaching somebody how to work out, teaching somebody how to eat. He does it for me. So one of the questions my patients ask when I say, I'd like to refer you to Orangetheory for your health and for losing weight, they say, so what really is Orangetheory? Why is it so different?
Yeah, so first of all, great to be here, Dr. Maupin. It's awesome to kind of be on this with you, and it's great to see what you're doing for health and helping people. That's probably the most common question we get with Orangetheory, and as the brand has kind of grown, it's starting to become more apparent. But Orangetheory is ultimately, it's a science-backed, technology-tracked, coach-inspired group workout. So it's all class-based. The classes are 1 hour long. Uh-huh. The workout's based on science, and we use treadmills, rowing machines, and then resistance training tools uh-huh. such as free weights, medicine balls, BOSU balls, benches, ab dollies to deliver sort of a very all-encompassing total body workout. The workout's going to consist of cardio, so you're getting that fat burn uh-huh. and calorie burn, and resistance training, so you're getting that muscle toning, muscle build. So it's very sort of all-encompassing. And then sort of another cool aspect is we wear heart rate monitors. So everyone that comes uh-huh. into the studio wears heart rate monitors. Uh-huh. Your real-time heart rate is displayed on flat screens in the studio. Uh-huh. So you can see exactly kind of how your body's responding to what you're doing during the workout and use uh-huh. that information to sort of push yourself accordingly.
And it's competitive because everybody's looking at what's happening on the screen. So my patients love it because most of my patients are very competitive and they say, I can see that I'm better than so and so and so and so. Or some people don't wear them because they don't want to be competitive, and that's fine too.
Exactly right. So ultimately, it's more or less a competition with yourself because we program the heart rate monitor based on your specific body, mm-hmm. Date of birth, weight, gender factors mm-hmm. into your max heart rate. So you're trying to get your own heart rate up to these target heart rate zones, and everyone's max heart rate's different. So you're really competing with yourself first and foremost. Mm-hmm. If you want to play up that competitive aspect mm-hmm. with other people in the studio, you can do that as well. But really, because everyone's different, we just sort of say, you want to try to compete with your own body to get the most out of your own workout.
That's a great method. So what do you do if people come and say, I don't like the treadmill. I don't like doing a stair stepper. I don't like free weights. How do you handle that?
So yeah, because Orangetheory is kind of all encompassing, it has a bunch of different components, we can make modifications mm-hmm. for any sort of like injury or orthopedic issue someone might have. Mm-hmm. The first thing we would do is ask someone, why, try to find mm-hmm. out why. Is it just because it's uncomfortable for you? Mm-hmm. Because sometimes, getting uncomfortable is the best way to get results.
Right.
If there's an injury, an orthopedic issue, we have alternative options. For instance, instead of the treadmill, we have a bike. Mm-hmm. We have an elliptical strider, so those are low-impact options. Mm-hmm. Our rowers are totally low-impact, so a lot of people that have knee issues, mm-hmm. the rower is a great tool for them. And then the free weights, if there's any jumping or anything that day, we can have the coaches who are expertly trained sort of modify anything that would need to be done so it wouldn't aggravate the issue, but they could still get something out of the workout.
You know, you mentioned that you want to get to a certain heart rate. So tell me why that is important. I don't think everyone knows how important that is for weight loss and for a healthy heart.
Absolutely. So Orangetheory, it's based on sort of interval training. So the idea is you want to get your heart rate up, bring it down, get it up, bring it down. Mm-hmm. So you want to kind of take your heart on a roller coaster ride. Sort of the alternative to that is steady state cardio, where if you go out and go for a jog, you go on a treadmill and you go for a jog, your heart rate's going to get up, but it kind of stays at the same mm-hmm. level and then comes back down. Mm-hmm. That's good, but interval training is going to be a lot more effective for burning fat, burning calories, mm-hmm. but also retaining muscle. So ultimately what we do is we'll set you up with a heart rate monitor. We personalize it based on all of your sort
individual
of bodily stats.
Individual treatment. I love it.
Yes. And your goal during the class is to get your heart rate up above 84% of its max mm-hmm. for 12 minutes or more during the hour-long mm-hmm. workout. If you do that, your body actually experiences this physiological response called the excess post-exercise oxygen consumption. Or
okay.
the EPOC effect, which
right.
you may know about. Mm-hmm. We call it the afterburn. Mm-hmm. Ultimately, what it means is if you get your heart rate up to certain zones for certain periods of time in the workout, mm-hmm. you're not only going to burn the calories you burn in the workout, but you'll burn calories for an additional 36 hours after the workout's over.
Perfect.
Exactly.
Perfect. And so that's like you don't have to exercise for 36 hours. You just get the benefit.
Exactly right. And that's kind of what everyone wants. And that's why people get such good results, mm-hmm. because we make it very, very efficient. Mm-hmm. And what happens is when you get your heart rate up, that's when you burn calories and fat. When you bring it down, mm-hmm. that's when you retain the muscle.
That's perfect.
If you yeah. were to, you know, just run all the time and we push you to your max all the time, what happens mm-hmm. is you burn calories and fat, but you also burn muscle.
Yeah.
We want to burn the calories and fat, but retain the muscle. So there's a mm-hmm. built-in recovery aspect where we're bringing your heart rate mm-hmm. down as well.
I know that Orangetheory sends your trainers, because I've talked to your mother, and your mother's a trainer and Olympic athlete. And so Julie has done this with me when we're on vacation. She just said, oh, I just got the new plan for what we're going to do this week. So she'll go through it. It's amazing. We did it, I think we were in Morocco, and we did it in the gym. And it was, it almost killed me. I mean, it was amazing. No, I loved it. But it was, she is so good. She's such a good teacher. And I know that you have all kinds of people that are almost as good as Julie teaching.
Yeah.
But they're all very sensitive to the needs of their clients.
Absolutely.
And that's what my patients really need. We both agree that you can't just exercise off calories and really lose weight unless you diet. And you can't diet without exercising. And this is the fastest weight loss I've ever seen in people. So we usually put them on a diet. We usually put them on on medications for weight loss if they need it, or if they have insulin resistance or diabetes, we treat it. And then we send them to Nick and to Orangetheory, and then they get their exercise that really stimulates it, because you can't just do one without the other. So this is something that people don't really think about. They think if they stop eating, they're just going to lose weight. Well, they'll lose muscle. And that's very important, not to lose muscle. Muscle is what testosterone gives you, and what we're always pitching is we need to make more muscle. But you literally can. I mean, you're going to lose muscle when you just diet, and that makes you skinny fat.
Absolutely. And to kind of piggyback off that, you know, I think what people don't understand is they think when they do a lot of cardio and just don't eat, they're gonna lose weight. But actually, if you have more muscle on your body, your metabolism is going to be higher, and mm-hmm. you're actually going to lose weight more because you're going to be burning more calories at rest.
Absolutely.
So I think that's how, you know, kind of Orangetheory and exercise ties into what you do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, testosterone helps build mm-hmm. muscle. Exercise helps build muscle.
Mm-hmm.
The more muscle you have, the more fat you're going to burn at rest.
Mm-hmm.
So you actually have to do less exercise when you have more muscle in your body. So that's why kind of, you know, you're trying to help people build more muscle. We're trying to help people build more
muscle.
But
the muscle has to be active. Even if you just build muscle, but you're not using it, then you're not really burning the optimal amount of calories. My patients come in and say, oh, look, I went on the body composition machine and I have all this muscle, so what do I need to do that for? So it's because you have to make your muscles active. You can't just sit there and thank God that you got muscles from your inheritance. You have to your genetics give you muscle, but if you don't use them, you're not gonna burn the calories that you could burn, and you're going to gain fat. And so that's why it dovetails with us so well. So I was interested in, you'll hate this because I didn't prep you for this, but I was interested in what you would do with someone who comes in and they have diabetes and they have a lot of other metabolic issues, but they're very overweight. And they really, I mean, how do you get them into this so that they're not throwing up or sucking air because they haven't ever exercised in their life?
Yeah, absolutely. And that's a very common question as well. The biggest sort of barrier with Orangetheory is, I feel like, intimidation. People get intimidated mm-hmm. by it. But sort of the best thing about it is it's totally modifiable based on kind of like your starting level. Mm-hmm. So what we do when someone comes in for their first class, we have a detailed intake form that goes through one, date of birth, weight, you know, gender, email, all that personal information. Then we ask health questions to make sure they're healthy. Mm-hmm. Then we go into kind of like what their goals are, mm-hmm. what they're looking for, what their barriers have been, mm-hmm. so we can personalize the experience towards them the best. Mm-hmm. If someone has certain health issues, we can modify the workout for them. Like, for instance, on the treadmill, you can be a runner, you can be a jogger, you can be a walker. A lot of people will walk, and then instead of increasing their speed to get their heart rate up, they'll mm-hmm. increase the inclines. They'll walk the hills. Mm-hmm. So that's very common. Mm-hmm. You know, we always say at Orangetheory we have, you know, a 25-year-old elite athlete next to, you know, a 75-year-old woman who hasn't worked out in 20 years. Mm-hmm. And they're both able to kind of coexist at their own level. Because, you know, the 25-year-old athlete's running at a 10 miles per hour. Mm-hmm. You know, the 75-year-old woman is walking at a 3 but using incline. Mm-hmm. And because she's older and her max heart mm-hmm. rate's lower, she's still able to get her heart rate up to the target zones.
Oh, that's amazing. How do you know when you're in the class that you're going to be running at a slower rate and the guy next to you is going to be running faster? How do you know that?
So we have paces. So we call our paces base, push, all out. Mm-hmm. And those paces are personal to you.
Okay.
So for instance, when you start the class, and we explained this before mm-hmm. the class, your base pace is kind of your 20-minute pace, mm-hmm. whatever that may be mm-hmm. for you. You know, yours mm-hmm. is different than mine.
Whatever you can do for 20 minutes.
Exactly, for about 20 minutes. So mm-hmm. I mean, you know, someone's 20-minute pace might be a 10 miles per hour. Another person's might be a 2 miles per hour. So that's your base.
Okay.
And then when we go to push pace, mm-hmm. that person who's a 10 might go to an 11. Mm-hmm. The person who's a 2 might go to a 3 or might mm-hmm. just use some incline. So it's all relative to
that's
where your
perfect.
Starting level is.
Yeah, and that really is what my patients need. They need coaching, and they need to know they aren't intimidated. If they're allowed to stay at the base and then they slowly come up, then that makes them much happier with the workout. My daughter's, after her baby, has become amazingly better. I mean, she's got muscle, she's lost fat, she's so excited. She can't live really without going to Orangetheory 3 times a week, and she may go more, but she's a lot happier too. That's the other thing that this type of workout does, is it makes your brain work better. And there are many studies that show that exercise really stimulates your thought process and allows you to think better through problems and problem solve. So anybody who tells me that they're really tired and when they go to work they can't think, I usually ask them to get up an hour early and then go to Orangetheory or work out on their own before they go to work so they can think through the day. They just have to remember to eat something, because if they don't, then they're going to crash.
Yeah.
And I usually advise them to have something like either electrolytes or a power shake before or after or both when their workouts. If they're not gaining enough muscle, I usually have them do the power shakes before and after. So I don't know if that goes in your within your treatment plan or.
Yeah. So first off, I totally agree. I mean, if you're sort of foggy or you're not sleeping, you have low energy mm-hmm. levels. I mean, exercise mm-hmm. usually helps all of those things. It gives you endorphins, you know, mm-hmm. so it sort of gives you that post-exercise glow. Usually mm-hmm. it exhausts you, so you sleep better. And, you know, it just makes things clearer for you. As far as nutrition's concerned, yeah, we definitely recommend, and this is something a lot of people don't know, in order to maximize your workout, you want to eat within 45 minutes of the end of your workout, mm-hmm. just because, you know, you want to replenish that protein and replenish mm-hmm. those carbohydrates to be able to, like, build your muscle and sort of replenish your energy stores.
So you may know this. I don't know how to do this, but I don't know what to tell vegans when they're trying to build muscle, because muscle is made out of animal muscle tissue, and I don't know what to tell them to do. I mean, if you have a trick, I'd love to hear it.
So
I didn't prep you for
this. Yeah, I don't have a ton of information on that, mm-hmm.
Have you run into it?
Yeah, we've run into it a little bit. I mean, there are animal proteins, like non-animal proteins, you know, mm-hmm. there's, you know, tofu mm-hmm. and, you know, other sort of plant-based proteins out there, especially this day and age mm-hmm. when, you know, there's a lot of people that are plant-based.
Mm-hmm. Pea protein, I know, works.
Yeah, pea protein. Mm-hmm. So I think with a little research, you know, there's a lot of plant-based alternatives that can give you muscle. Mm-hmm. I actually watched a documentary recently, they talked about how it was a plant-based documentary, and they talked about how the biggest, strongest animals on Earth don't eat meat. So if you mm-hmm. look at an ox, mm-hmm. they always say strong as an ox, mm-hmm. and oxes are totally plant-based. Elephants are totally plant-based.
Except they have a different stomach and they have a different...
Yeah, like, well, exactly.
For example, dogs don't need to take vitamin C because they make it in their liver.
Okay.
And vitamin D as well. So they have different metabolisms. So that's kind of a... That doesn't play for me.
Yeah,
But you do have to be very careful about your protein.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, I just think, you know, point is there are ways to get protein without just animal protein. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think animal protein is the best way to do it. But I think, you know, if someone's made that choice,
and if anybody in our listeners, out of all 6,000 of you, if you could, you can email me with an idea of how to get protein from a plant-based diet that will actually build muscle. A type of protein, maybe a shake or some special combination that would help my patients make their muscle, because I researched it. I couldn't find it. So that would be very helpful. But anybody, any age, any condition can do Orangetheory because they're working against themselves and they're actually competing with themselves, kind of like golf.
Sort of,
kind
yeah.
of, unless you're on the tour. So you get better and you feel better about yourself. So this is my choice for people who are trying to lose weight and build muscle from my practice. And Nick has made his Orangetheory special. He has one in Chesterfield. Actually, it's with his brothers, with Andy and Connor and Nick all together on these two Orangetheories. And they've made them better. They are dedicated to how to take care of my patients. And they give them special attention, and I really appreciate that. I want you to think about going to an Orangetheory near you or in St. Louis, coming to Nick's Orangetheories, and actually trying it. Just give it a try and see how much you like it. You won't be able to stop. Thank you for listening today. Thank you, Nick, for coming here and talking to us and taking time out of your busy day to discuss this and help people understand how to get better, how to get thinner, how to get better muscle mass.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.
So Nick, how can anyone get a hold of you or get to your Orangetheory to come in as a new client or patient?
Absolutely. So Orangetheory does first class free. So if you've never taken a class before, you can take your first class for free, which is
That's a great
way to experience the workout, just because it's something different and something mm-hmm. new. I have two locations in St. Louis that so I own with my brothers, Connor and Andy. Mm-hmm. The Ladue location is 10277 Clayton Rd. It's right in the Schnook Shopping Center mm-hmm. at Clayton and Lindbergh. Mm-hmm. The Chesterfield location is 1674 Clarkson Rd. It's right mm-hmm. at Clarkson and Baxter, sort of mm-hmm. in the heart of Chesterfield. I think you're going to link the website and the contact info. One thing I will say as well is all Orangetheory classes are nationally reciprocal. So mm-hmm. if you have classes at one location, mm-hmm. you can use them anywhere in the entire country. There's 1,200 studios in the country. People really like that because if they're traveling for work mm-hmm. or for pleasure, they can continue with sort of the program and not get off track when they're traveling. Mm-hmm. Or if they're in St. Louis, there's 12 studios in St. Louis. Wherever you are throughout your day, mm-hmm. if there's a time that works better than another, mm-hmm. you can go to a different studio and the classes are good at any location.
That's great. I love how you schedule too, because you schedule on your phone.
Exactly, yeah.
So you can put yourself in a class. If there's an opening, you can put yourself in a class. I would love to schedule our patients that
yeah,
way.
That's...
You know, it's a great scheduling program. So it makes it so easy to get a class that you can fit into.
That's exactly right. So it's all class-based. So we have scheduled class times. Mm-hmm. People say that helps with accountability when you have it on your schedule. Mm-hmm. We have an app. You schedule directly from the app. You can cancel mm-hmm. classes from the app. So all of your scheduling is managed by you. So it makes it kind of fun for people. And then just having that, you know, scheduled class time, it makes it sort of like an appointment in your day. You're much more likely to go do it.
That's
Whereas
true.
If it's a regular gym, you know, I'm going to go.
I'm going to go. I'm going to go.
Yeah.
I'm going to go. And then I'm going to bed.
Exactly. I'm going to watch TV.
So, okay. Well, thank you very much. That's very helpful for our patients to know how to get a hold of you and how to become an Orangetheory client.
Of course.
Email your questions or comments to podcast@biobalancehealth.com. You can find the BioBalance HealthCast on iTunes and on YouTube. For more information about bioidentical hormone pellet therapy and other reverse aging solutions, visit biobalancehealth.com or call 314-993-0963. You can find Dr. Maupin on Twitter at Dr. Kathy Maupin and on Facebook at facebook.com/biobalancehealth. Find Brett Newcomb at brettnewcomb.com.